Welcome to PicoBYTE, the top tip series that doesn't show up at your front door to sell your stuff.
PicoScope 7 is the...
Masks are an extremely useful and versatile tool within PicoScope 7. Using these alongside actions allow you to view any anomalies within the data stream, a clock pulse, a DC waveform, or even a DC voltage dropout. Setting up a mask is simple. Launch PicoScope 7, plug in your PicoScope, and get your signal probed up. Once everything is stable and visible, launch the mask dialog and click Generate Mask from Source. This will create a mask in blue generated around your signal by an offset defined by these X and Y values. If you have lots of jitter and frequency variance or amplitude variance in your signal, you'll want to increase these X and Y values to compensate for the error in the signal. But usually the standard values will do the job. Once you're happy with the masks, click Apply and Close, or you can export your mask to save and use later. Now you have your mask set up, you'll see this dialog here showing the total fails and passes. But as we've just got a simple sine wave that follows the mask almost perfectly, we're not getting any issues. A mask fail would be any signal that visually passes through the blue mask that's been created. Each fail creates an orange line in the mask that will stay there until the settings are changed or the capture restarts. In this example, if I adjust the frequency and the sine wave slightly, it will start to fail and the corresponding counter will start to increase and we'll get our orange line of what the failed capture actually looked like. Other fails we can look for using this method would be runt pulses or glitches in a square wave clock signal, or a voltage dropout of a power supply. If you have a really fast signal and you can't seem to capture a pulse, you could try using the rapid block triggering, which will take a certain amount of captures without missing any due to processing. Now, if we want to do more than just display these failed captures, we'll need to use our actions. Actions allows you to make PicoScope 7 do something when a certain event happens. This event could be single capture, a full buffer, or a mask pass or fail. Once you have your event selected, there's a multitude of different ways you can process the data with the actions. You can stop your capture and produce a beep or chime to let you know something has stopped working or something's happened with your signal. You could stop, save your data in a PS data file, and then you can send that to your colleagues or tech support. Or you could save it to a CSV or text file to add it to a spreadsheet or database later. You could also take the CSV and then run a scripted application in Python, MATLAB or C to take that data and then process it into a visual representation to verify the data or automatically post the data online. You could use the trigger signal generator action, where on a mask failure, you could send a voltage signal to a device to tell it to stop performing a certain test or activate a different test. By using a mixture of these actions, you can create all sorts of different sequences when a mask fails or passes. You could even think outside the box by using a mask pass as a trigger. For example, if you want to test a serial protocol bus for no acknowledgement, you can create a mask out of a failed test and configure the action to only trigger when the mask passes. Masks in PicoScope 7 are super easy to set up and the provided actions give you lots to play with. So go nuts, have a play with some of the above examples to see how masks could help you with your own work. And I have a job to get to.
Yeah?
Good day.
Good day!
Have you heard of an oscilloscope? Hello, boss. It's not going well. They keep saying, have you heard of the internet?